line. Fourth phase, fifth phase now. And now, great ball taken by Josh McClarty. Can he hold on to it in traffic?
He's done an excellent job.
And they're over the line now. And now the Camels countering with a counter maul here. And the ball staying and spilling out now, but not a knock-on. And there is the scrum half, McLeod. So the Camels really driving Aurora back some 5 or 6 meters from the earlier attacks. But Aurora still showing that there's someone to be dealt with here. Game tied at 18-all. Everyone starts playing defense with a new serious attitude. That's the hooker, Selvaggi. He gets it out to Resnick, his prop. And look at how much ground Aurora has given up here in this attack. Now that's Chung. He is
strong,
a big
man.
Yeah, he's able to keep those legs pumping. And now a pass from the ground and immediately brought down was Heyman.
Boy, it was a wonderful offload from Heyman, too.
Now, full attack on, that's the outside center dropping it, Mike Neely. And now Barron's got to clean that up, and they're going to clean the slate and give it another go. And look, it makes a couple of good first steps, and then he is just gang-tackled. And all for naught, as we're going to play the advantage back behind the play. Joyce Henry indicating a knock-on that came from Mike Neely.
Yeah, no advantage was gained from that.
She might have blown that whistle before Ivan Barron got folded up like a card table there. But
maybe she's got something against him. Who knows?
Yeah.
But what a mistake off the kickoff. That's a very costly error. Nolan Ott was through there just like an 18-year-old version of Nolan Ott.
Yeah.
He's still very quick around this park, isn't he?
He sure is. And he's just added so much size that it must be frightening to have to bring him down. So the put in is clean from Lucas Wright, but that scrum has gone bad, but not before they spin it out. And now it's Windsor playing off to the right hand side, and he's given some pressure relief with a kick to touch that will put the Barbarians with the throw in 10 meters or 8 meters inside the Stony Creek half.
Yeah, that's the Camels had the initial shove and wheeled it intentionally to the right, giving their scrum half some protection. And just a nice feed back to 10 to clear his lines.
Heyman with a good throw down the middle, but McSwiggin couldn't get to it. And now Windsor with a great probing kick in behind DiGirolamo, who lets it roll behind the 22, and he's got a man on him. But that's not going to bother a veteran like that. And he puts a good clearance kick down the line. And, boy, that is a superb kick by DiGirolamo, who also covers
kick.
It right afterwards to say, hey, you're not going to throw it into yourself and make me look like
a defensive monkey. Just a little too ambitious. The idea is right, put it in behind the defense, but Girolamo did extremely well. I mean, what a kick. That's a good 50-meter clearance.
Oh, yeah. And, you know, he was known for his kicking different times. He was a scrum half for Canada and played fly half for Canada when he needed to, and his sevens experience. So he's got all the skill sets you need as the new pub owner, Kieran McSwiggin, gets that ball out the line. And
the burning barn.
Yeah. And that's a step in by Eric Selvaggi. Selvaggi, I know it's a soft G, and I just...
That certainly looked like yes. Yeah. She has the referee has indicated that the man came in from an offside position. Certainly correct in that decision. Very, very dangerous.
Things getting a little hot down there now. And after what happened last week on the sidelines, we want to see things played cleanly and fairly between these two teams, which they've done for the most part. You
Absolutely.
Know, a little shoulder to shoulder is never too serious, but...
Yep, a very, very good, solid kick, setting up an attacking line out just outside the 22. I would think that the barbs here will just spin wide, see what happens.
Under 2 minutes to go here with these two teams tied at 18-all. And, boy, it's just been a real treat watching the back and forth of this game.
It is a good game, Doug.
And that's Gian Montino bringing that ball down. The big man keeping the ball on Barbarian side. Ball coming down the line now for the Barbarians.
Look at the wheels on Bugatti.
Bugatti, and he steps in one. Oh, and he had a player in front of him. Argument could be made he was kind of the pulling guard there on that one. And So the luckily the penalty wasn't called there, and it was completely inadvertent, but it was more Buiatti was just coming up so fast that his player couldn't get out of the way. Barb's been pushed back a couple meters here, and they'll be scrummed to the Stoney Creek team.
What a great attacking movement. Ball came quickly out to here we go. We're going to have a look at this replay on the replay. Tom McLeod puts a great ball out to Sean Sennell, miss out, and Bugatti comes into the line, and unfortunately number 13 gets in front. But
Neely puts his hands up to sort of say, I'm not supposed to be here, I know it, but probably drew more attention to himself than he needed to.
Yeah, it wasn't material, so well done by the referee to allow that to go. Very, very strong defense again.
Yeah, technically it was wrong, but it didn't affect the outcome of the play, so... Here's Stoney Creek with the put in. This is an important clearance kick for Windsor, who set up right of that scrum. And Barbarians definitely have a tactic that they want to twist that wheel, that scrum every time, and put them under pressure and take Dave Wilson out of the play a little bit with his pick and goes from the back of the scrum.
Oh, turnover. What a...
Stolen, and now Nolan Ott's got it. And that's Sennell. Sennell's going to score under the post, just right of the post. And been saying his name all afternoon long, but Nolan Ott gets it out and... ultimately, it was at the fly half. Yeah, Sean Sennell that scored that.
I mean, here we've got the ball clearly turned over. Well done. Nolan Ott stepping off his left foot. And a nice little soft pass to Sean Sennell, who just runs through the defense to score. A little easier than Stoney Creek would certainly wish it to be.
So 23-18 with an easy conversion kick to come from Buiatti. And... So that will probably take us into the halftime break and watch Stoney Creek coach Gary Whitley and Kerry Byrne head down to talk to their charges in a moment. And I don't think they'll be necessarily upset. I think it was a good first half of rugby from both teams.
A very, very worrying concern as we see David Wilson, who's heavily strapped up, coming off the pitch, limping badly.
So he already had a problem that's been aggravated. And 41 minutes gone, the score is 23-18. And
did they make the kick?
Yes, the kick did go through for 25-18. And so for the moment, the Barbarians in the driver's seat here, but we'll have enough time for one more play, it seems, the restart. And we've had a replacement as Wilson has come off, and just wait for that jersey number to unroll on the player's back there and see who it is that's come in. That's number 21, Ian Davies, on for the back rower, Dave Wilson.
Well, not much left in this half. Let's see if Aurora
would probably just be happy to get this ball. Instead, they tap it on the knock-on to the Camels, and will the Camels get a last gasp here? And try and tie this game up again.
It's a comedy of errors. A knock-on from... look at those...
They're knock-on by Stoney Creek now, but there's going to be a penalty before that. And so here, Stoney Creek, you got a chance. Do you think Windsor goes for goal here? Or, just to try and claw back that score? No, she's indicating, Joyce Henry, that they've got enough time to get the line out here.
This
so,
might be the last
they're backing
play.
Themselves. Yeah, it would be the last play, but... Good on Stoney Creek to say, hey, I don't care what the clock says. We've got enough time here to score another try. Let's do it.
That was a phase that had all kinds of errors. Knocked on by Aurora, kicked forward in error. Again, turned over. Strange, strange game.
So Phil Jackson getting that ball in. No, the great basketball coach is not taking up rugby. Different Phil Jackson. To 5 meters out now. Camels with a loose ball. They've gathered it in, but they have had to eat up some territory at the same time. They've lost 5 meters. Windsor with the offload. A Barbarian hand got in there. Now it's Ivan Barron, and they'll look to just get that ball into touch at this point. And now DiGirolamo smartly kicks that into touch.
And older.
That'll be halftime, yeah.
An older, wiser head.
Oh, yeah, he saw things were not going well. Let's just get this thing into touch, and let's go have a drink and talk about things. What are you guys doing? Yeah. So great first half of rugby here from Douglas Horn Stadium at Fletcher's Field, where the Aurora Barbarians are leading the Stoney Creek Camels 25-18. Second half action coming up. You're watching Ontario Rugby on Rogers Television.
Happening in your community this summer? It's easy.
The event is coming.
Watch the Bulletin Board to learn about all the great events happening throughout the region. So tune in to the Bulletin Board Summer Edition Monday at 12:30 p.m. only on Rogers TV.
Come on, let's get this movie started. I'm good.
Watch the hottest new releases and thousands of other movies with Rogers On Demand. Now playing American Reunion. Go to channel 100 to order.
Hi, I'm Mercedes Jones. Join me each week as I welcome guest experts to talk about bringing sexy back into your life. We'll explore one common issue each week and give some no-nonsense tips to help. Tune in. This week could be when we talk about that question you've always wanted an answer to but couldn't drum up the courage to ask. That's on Bringing Sexy Back, Tuesdays and Thursdays at 10:30 p.m. only on Rogers TV.
I am Alan Drummond, an emergency physician in Perth, Ontario. I see the tragic consequences of improperly handled firearms too often. It is important to store firearms safely to prevent loss or theft, injuries, and death. If there are firearms in your home, be sure they are unloaded and locked before storing. Store them in a firearms cabinet. Store the ammunition separately and lock it up. You can help stop firearms tragedies before they reach my emergency department. Be responsible, prevent a tragedy. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Emily Kloss. Join us in class this week. We're focusing on sun salutations. See you on the mat.
Watch Yoga Flow with Emily, Wednesdays at 6 a.m., only on Rogers TV.
And welcome back to Douglas Horn Stadium at Fletcher's Field, where we're about to get underway the second half. This great game between the Aurora Barbarians, Stoney Creek Camels, Aurora leading 25-18. We've had a number of lead changes, a couple of tie scores at 13-18. Doug Cross along with Steve Scott as Joyce Henry gets this game back underway. Stoney Creek coming up with the ball off that kickoff. And as greatly gathered in by their captain, Sean Windsor. And first attack by the Camels, and things looking good for the wing, Andrew Porter, as he drives through before Barbarians arrive in numbers. Here's the scrum half, Lucas Wright. He offloads that quickly, but met with firm Barbarian resistance. Now that ball has come out Barbarian side, it looks like, as they excitedly try and come up with that ball.
That was Donnie Redizic that came in unfortunately was responsible for turning the ball over to Aurora. Now we have a penalty, and it's going to be a kicked up the field for an attacking line out from the Ibrahim Bugatti. Bugatti's played an excellent match.
And he's scored two tries, but also been instrumental in linking up for other tries. One that saw Sinel score out wide, and then this Barbarians team showing a lot of enterprise, but Camels no slouches either. And I think this team, both these teams, are going to go through a few phases this afternoon of success before this one is settled.
What an expensive error that is. Not straight at the line out. There's very, very few excuses for that kind of poor play.
Henry calling for a scrum in 15. That will be Camels put in. So number 9, Lucas Wright, will put that ball in. These scrums have been very even, but the tactic by the Barbarians to try and twist that scrum has been paying off for them.
Mike Rao has gone in at number 8.
And now Barbarians being penalized. Crooked arm penalty there, and the flanker, number 6, Michael Rao, quick up on that opportunity. And quick ball out and drop ball by number 13, Jeff Grollo. like to have that one back because they're in a good attacking position there.
We can all feel for a play like that where you take your eyes off the ball because you're thinking of what you're going to do.
Yeah, you know, you can receive 1,000 passes in your life, but you just have to lose focus for an instant, and it's a foreign thing to do.
Now, scrums have been very entertaining. Stony Creek have put pressure on Aurora, but with Nolan Ott back there, he's been able to clean up and turn some pretty poor ball into a decent platform for his backs.
And now another penalty against the Barbarians at the scrum. So what's going on in the front row there, Steve Scott?
Well, it's a good question. Either we've got a situation where there's been an early bind, or they're coming in early and it's not waiting for the command, or I'm wondering if there might have been a foot up.
And Stony Creek showing they're happy to have the scrum. On the option, they opt for another scrum rather than kicking or spinning it out.
Yeah, they definitely have confidence in their scrummage ability. We have a new number 8, as I mentioned earlier. Michael Rao has moved back in there, and we have a replacement, Donnie Radizic, playing in the pack.
Wearing the number 16 jersey. Spin pass from right, and now going right down the camel line, but not in hand. And now that's Porter trying to make some lemonade out of that lemon, and he's managed to keep that ball. Stony Creek side, right. Good service to his fly half, Windsor. And big tackles being put in tight. Right, giving that out to the Donnie Radizic that you just mentioned, who's come into the game at flanker. And I'm really impressed by Stony Creek and their ability to attack here in close. Good crisp passing and every touch of the ball, netting some yardage across the gain line. And Grollo, no, that wasn't Grollo this time, that was David Jones. The mishandling in two critical spots where they're putting the pressure on and they just can't close the door.
Very uncharacteristic of David Jones. He's, as I mentioned earlier in the broadcast, he's a very, very experienced player, normally at home in any of the back positions. But it's a different situation when you have somebody coming up at you very quickly and you're trying to weigh your options. You have to concentrate on the ball as it comes into your hands.
We were talking about, you know, the fact that the Camels are 3-3 on the season, but they're within spitting distance of this Aurora team this afternoon. What a big win this could be if they could come away with a victory on the road against Aurora.
Well, that's an interesting decision. We have another free kick.
Now it's gone back the other way to Trevor Atkinson. And Camels are not there in big numbers at the breakdown, and they better do something with it quick before the Barbarians decide to pour through. Is that a grubber or was that a drop? It was more a grubber, and now that's going to just die in a perfect spot. Oh, and boy, a Camel player over there. I think that was Porter just where, no, the, maybe Cody Taylor just about got to that.
Well, if he's not a track runner, he certainly got him there quickly enough like he was.
And we saw earlier when Buiatti beat the player in the first half going from the chip through from Ott. So goes both ways.
That's a deep dropout, isn't it?
Mm. Normally you see a little more loft on those kicks, and that goes right into touch. And Stony Creek will have the throw-in. So simple mistakes being made by both teams here.
Yeah. Now it's a very good opportunity for Creek. They're just inside the 10 meters. So let's see what they do with this ball, if they're able to win it from the top.
Phil Jackson going to the back of the scrum, of the line out there, but a bit of a loose ball after they came down with it.
It was well taken initially, but a very poor offload, not held, and spilled ball, no advantage gained. So scrummage now to Aurora.
Great to see Nolan Ott. It's such a wrecking crew, pounding people, but then they're all happy to slap him on the back. And, you know, he's got a lot of friends in rugby out there. And sure. I think people just respect how hard he plays, but he plays fair. You know, he's never going to be the stuff behind the play that would get you in front of the director of discipline.
He's earned a very good reputation within the game. Speaking of tanks, I just saw Steve Shortley warming up. Probably one of the hardest running centers that has ever played in the top division in Ontario.
That'd be a big offensive choice for the Barbarians early in the second half. Look at the drive by the Blue standing up that Barb's front row, but not before the ball comes out. And now that's the fullback. No, that wasn't the fullback either. That was Mike Neely. And now Ott banging his way through for a couple of extra meters. That Stony Creek player not getting out of the way quick enough. Gian Montino, the second row wearing number four, and I'm sure he could slot in at prop at some point this afternoon. And he'd be DiGirolamo now. He's come through the gap. Nice offload to the hooker. Salvaggi still on his feet. Now the scrum half, McLeod, looking for the next offload, and that's going to be Buiatti in for his third of the afternoon. That is Ibrahim Buiatti, and what a clinic of try scoring he's put on this afternoon.
Well, we can't see it from the camera, but David Wilson has been playing, the fellow that came off with a bad knee. Nolan Ott ran over and offered his hand and helped him to his feet as Wilson leaves the game the second time. Sorry, we've got the replay there.
Stepped through, did a great job scoring that try, all off the hard work of Marco DiGirolamo, who had found the gap and went some 20, 25 meters before he found the sweet spot to offload to the fullback. And he has had a special afternoon. And maybe the wheel's getting a little creaky on the Stony Creek camel train here.
Yeah, what a player this guy's turned out to be, Buhati. Nice, soft swing.
Adds another two, and it's 32-18 with 49 minutes gone in this second half.
That was almost like a nine iron, eh? Just mm-hmm. a nice, easy swing.
Bet you is a good golfer. Someone who's got muscle memory control like that, they tend to be good at those kind of sports. Whereas my spastic motions on the driving range usually result in a call to the police and ambulance. But
well, I always think it's a bit of a charity. You buy golf balls and you give them away. You just leave them in other places for people to find them.
Yeah, it's an Easter egg hunt of sorts. So we got Windsor is going to get this started, and they really must score the next points of the game to keep this one within reach.
It's a great kickoff.
And the Camels have come away with it after a couple of bobbled possessions by the Barbarians, just 10 meters out now. And my words may be prophetic if they can put this across. They've got numbers out wide if they can just get the ball out there, but instead they're tied up by Trevor Atkinson going into contact there.
Turned
and,
over.
Yeah, Barbarians have pinched that ball. And there's who else? Nolan Ott linking up out wide. And now it's Buiatti kicking that on as he got the gas to get to that ball. First he does, but oh, agonizingly, that ball just bounced out into touch before he could get his foot to it. And now quick throw in, not being accepted by Joyce Henry. You know, a lot of people might think it was because he didn't throw it in straight, but perhaps someone else touched it before they went to do the restart.
Yeah, it's a tough one for the referees because just outside of the sideline is a fence, and if a ball hits the fence, you know,
it's giving unfair advantage instead of the ball having just died there, it bounces back. And
yeah, it's a tough call, that one.
Phil Jackson throwing in, bit of a messy ball, goes Barb's side now.
Costly mistake.
That's Nolan Ott who came down with it. And that's Eric Salvaggi going in hard, but not making too much ground there. Gian Montino, number four, trying to pick up a couple of Stony Creek players and get them out of there. And Miss Joyce Henry agreed with that situation. Stony Creek players not rolling away. And, you know, Gian was taking the law in his own hands and getting those guys out of there like cordwood.
Yeah, Steve Johnson found himself on the wrong side, not only of Joyce Henry's decision, but on the wrong side of the ball. So just staying in the wrong position, slowing the ball down.
Marco DiGirolamo brought the ball forward, put it down on the ground, indicated we're going for post, and Buiatti is going to line this one up, and no suggestion that he should miss from this distance the way he's been kicking.
No, he's a very good kicker, isn't he? An all-round, very fine display today.
So if he makes this kick, it'll be 35-18 for the Barbs. Well struck, but I think it might have gone wide. No, yeah, the flag stayed down.
And so, you know, it didn't look like his normal smooth kick. It, you know, maybe there's a bit of a mental issue there where he was thinking about something.
The Stoney Creek, I don't know why they're restarting. Oh, that was a penalty. I'm sorry. I was thinking it was a conversion, right? So Stoney Creek is restarting from behind their own 22. And smartly, I've seen so many players trying to do the restart right at the 22 and get balls charged down. You can retreat behind your 22 and kick from anywhere. But that ball doesn't go into touch, nor was it meant to, as now Nolan Ott, the 310 from Yuma, coming through there and crashing through a wall of blue there.
Yeah, on the bottom of that was number four, Evan Smith.
Jesse Heyman going in hard now, the flanker for Aurora, but not before a blast of the whistle from Joyce Henry. And now a bit of confusion, the Barb's players not understanding it was against them, but not releasing the ball at the breakdown.
Yeah, we're getting a fair number of penalties at the breakdown. It's a very, very difficult area to control. You know, there has to be a fine balance between prevention and penalty.
Shank kicked by Sean Windsor is going to go over the dead ball line. That's going to result in a scrum back all the way back. That's a huge error by Windsor, and heads-up play by DiGirolamo to let that roll over the dead ball line. So everyone's going to come back, and we'll have a scrum to Aurora inside Stoney Creek half.
What a major error that is. That's.
I don't think he ever pictured that happening when he kicked that ball, but it shanked off the right side of his boot and just kept going and going, and I think assisted with a little bit of a tailwind there too. So what? Just for people watching at home who don't understand what happened, what's the law in this position, Steve, where you're kicking for touch like that?
Yeah, if the ball goes dead through the in goal, then you have the option of a 22 or scrum back. And, of course, the obvious choice there is the scrum back.
Yeah, about a 50-meter advantage over
ball against the head.
So a big steal by Stoney Creek. We haven't seen that much this afternoon. Looks like Rao taking that into contact.
Yeah, I think you're right. That's the first ball against the head that either team have managed today.
So Stoney Creek showing they're still interested in playing in this game, and certainly in the physical aspect of the game, they're doing well. Barb's player down, the fly half, Sinel, maybe waving off his trainer from coming on the field, but certainly he's not 100% just yet.
Strong counter rucking.
Now tight spin pass to Windsor. He misses out one. And Aurora sliding across for the drift defense. Great offload back to Windsor as the player is tackled. And his opposite number, Sinel, brings him down. Pick and drive now. Driven back hard. That was the wing, Cody Taylor, trying to take that on. Now, Barbs have stolen that ball. DiGirolamo acting as a scrum half, but he's wrapped up right away. Gian Montino got that ball from him.